You heard about the big wedding? Our whole town has come. They've been feasting for 4 days already.
4 days?
Yes, and it's going to go much longer. There's delicious food, music.
Music?
Will there be dancing too? I will finally have a chance to show my skills at the Hawaiian torch dance. No!
Hello, my dear friends on YouTube. This is Isaacra here. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today, I'd like to share with you again about Superbook. And the episode I present you today is Jesus Feeds the Hungry. And the life lesson we can learn from this episode, Jesus Feeds the Hungry, is whatever Jesus says to you, do it. The little he asks from you will be multiplied in his hands. Now, let me share with you about, can Jesus do something with what little things I have? Mary told the servants to do whatever Jesus told them. All Jesus asked was to fill the 6 jars with water. The servants obeyed and Jesus performed a miracle to change that water into wine. Jesus took the little boy's food he had brought that day, blessed it and multiplied the food to feed over 5,000 people with 12 baskets left over. Think of this. The entire universe was formed at God's command. His word made the heavens, and by his breath the stars were born. God formed man from the dust of the ground and breathed life into him. Hebrews chapter 11 verse 3, Psalms chapter 33 verse 6, and Genesis chapter 2 verse 7. Never wonder if Jesus can do something with what we offer him. Jesus will take what we bring and multiply it. Andrew and Philip didn't see how the crowd could be fed, and they wanted to send the crowd away to find food. They quickly learned what Jesus could do with just 5 loaves of bread and 2 small fish the little boy obediently offered to Jesus. There is no limit to what Jesus can do with what little we have. Now let me share with you about Andrew. It was evening. Andrew asked Jesus to send away the tired and hungry crowd to find a place to stay and eat. Instead, Jesus instructed his disciples to sit the people down in the grass. Andrew had noticed a young boy who had brought a basket of food containing 5 loaves of barley bread and 2 small fish. He asked the boy to bring the food to Jesus, even though he didn't think it would do much good. Philip must have been amazed as he gave the food to the crowd after Jesus had miraculously multiplied it. Imagine his thoughts as he and the other disciples gathered 12 baskets of leftovers after over 5,000 people had eaten all they wanted. We can read about Andrew in Matthew chapter 4, John chapter 1, Mark chapter 13, John chapter 6, and John chapter 12. Now let me share with you about Philip. Jesus found Philip in Galilee and said, "Come follow me." Philip found Nathanael and told him to come see Jesus for himself. Philip was one of Jesus' chosen apostles. We can read about Philip in John chapter 1, Matthew chapter 10, John chapter 6, John chapter 12, and John chapter 14. Now let me share with you about the little boy who shared the fish and bread with Jesus. Nathan is the name given to the young boy in the Bible story. He brought 5 loaves of barley bread and 2 small fish that day to hear Jesus teach and hopefully see Jesus perform miracles. He offered his small amount of food to Jesus and watched him take the loaves and give thanks to God. Nathan was amazed to see his food feed over 5,000 people who ate all they wanted. After they were finished eating, Jesus' disciple gathered over 12 baskets of leftovers. Nathan was sure glad he didn't forget to bring his lunch basket that day. He learned that there was nothing Jesus couldn't do. We can read about this boy in John chapter 6 and Matthew chapter 14. Now let me share with you about Master of Ceremony at Cana. The master of the banquet tasted the water that had been turned into wine. He did not realize where it had come from, though the servants who had drawn the water knew. Then he called the bridegroom aside. We can read about this event in John chapter 2. Dear friends, I hope you are encouraged by the content I present you today while presenting Superbook episodes Jesus Feeds the Hungry, episode 1, season 4. Thank you for watching and being with us throughout this video, and I hope you are encouraged by the God's word I present you today. Please like, share, comment and subscribe our channel for more videos similar to this. And don't forget to read the Bible every day and be encouraged yourself.